Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today I am going to explain how we can fill the Excel file to calculate the course learning outcome achievement. First of all, I will briefly explain the sheets which are available in this Excel file. This Excel file is prepared in Excel software, and this Excel file currently supports 35 students, as you can see here. So the first sheet, as you can see, the name of this sheet is students. So in this sheet we have to fill the student information, student ID and student name. So we have to fill for all the students, those are available in our course here. Maybe this file supports 35 students, maybe the number of students in your course are less. Then I will explain that how you have to remove the remaining slides. So before here, because this I am working in Najran University, and this Excel file is prepared according to the our requirement. So first thing, that is the department. So you have to click here and you have to change the department. What is your department? Our department is the College of Computer Science and Information System, the class information BSc. And this achievement report was prepared for second semester, suppose 2013-2014. So you have to update this according to your information. After that, you have to give the section. If your course have the multiple sections, you have to specify the section, course code, course title, and credit hours. Okay, number of students, how many students, and the instructor name. So this is the basic information you can see on the top of each sheet. So you have to fill on the first sheet, and remaining sheets it will be copied. So this is the first information you have to fill here. Then you have to specify the student names here, and after that you have to specify the course learning outcomes. How many course learning outcome you have in this course? For example, the sample which I am going to present here, that is for the course operating systems. For example, in this operating system, each instructor always prepare the course syllabus, and which is distributed to the students in the first lecture. So for example, if you see, this is the course description for my course. Okay. And from this description, we have designed 6 learning outcomes. So these are the 6 learning outcomes we have. The first learning outcome, describe operating system history, services, application and type. And for your course, of course, you will have the course learning outcome. And normally recommended course learning outcomes are from 5 to 10. So in this course, I have only 6 course learning outcomes. But this Excel file, you can see it support the 10 course learning outcome. So if the number of course learning outcomes are less, so simply we have to remove the course learning outcome. So we have to keep in mind that we are going to evaluate our course learning outcomes. So we have to map our questions with the learning outcomes. So we have multiple assessment method. So here I will explain you about the evaluation method. For example, if you see this one, that in this course evaluation scheme, I have the theory assignment, and we give the weight 5% for theory assignments. Now it's up to the instructor, or it's up to on the policy of the college, that how many assignment weightage, how much will be the quiz weightage. But in Najran University, we have the midterm exam 15%, midterm exam 2 15%, final exam that is 40%, and labs 20%. So we have quiz and assignment total 10%. So we have to make our evaluation of the students based on this evaluation scheme. Now I am going to follow this evaluation scheme. So if you have something change, so you have to follow according to your, but it will support, Excel file will support any type of evaluation scheme. But these are the common common evaluation methods that we use in the course. So now we will move to the Excel file. So what we have to do first, that we have to fill this information, the first information about the instructor, about the course, about section, semester. Okay, so after that we need to fill the student information. For example, I suppose here the number of students in my course are only 10, and you can see here this Excel file support 35 students. So what I will do, just I will select the after 10, you can see here after 10, just I will select the remaining number of students and just I will delete them. I will click and just I will delete. Now I have only 10 students. If I go to the next slide, so I will show you that how you have to delete from there with the same methods. Just select. Now maybe you have 20 students, you have to keep the 20 rows and remaining you have to delete for to make it easy. So I have deleted. Now you can see the sample I already filled. So this is the 10 students, this is the student ID and this is the name of the student. You can write in Arabic, you can write in English. Okay, so it's up to you. So when I copy this name here, so you can see here, if I go to the next sheet quizzes, you will see the names are automatically copied in all the sheets. You can see here, so just only on the first sheet you need to copy. After that we have to, after filling this information, we need to go to the second sheet, that is CLOs. CLOs mean course learning outcome. As I explained that in this course I have the only 6 course learning outcomes, so I will keep 6 and remaining same way I will select and I will simply delete, and then I will write here what is the first learning outcome, what is the second, and so on. So in the sample you will find that I already fill this, the course learning outcome 1 is the describe operating system history, services, application and types, apply Unix command to perform essential operation, CLO 3 and so on. I have copied the course learning outcomes on this sheet. Now I will move to the third sheet, that is related to the quizzes. So here you can see that because we have this information is coming from the previous slide, this matrix quiz and course learning outcome matrix, that is very important. And here this Excel file support 4 quizzes, quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3, quiz 4. So normally in a class there are only maximum I think it is 4 quiz, not more than this. So what you need to do, the first thing you need to do here, because our learning outcomes are only 6, so we need to select the remaining this and we need to just simply delete this. We have only 6 learning outcomes, so better to remove the remaining one. We are, you can see here, on quizzes sheet. So for quizzes we have separate sheet, for assignment we have separate, we for midterm exam we have separate sheet to make it more easy to understand. So we have number of students are 10, so remaining this information, because this file support 35 students, so remaining we need to delete. So we have 10 students. Okay, now we will move to the sample, that how to fill this. I have only 10 students and according to my plan I have only 2 quizzes. So what I need to do, remaining 2 quizzes 3 and 4 I have to select and just simply I have to delete. Okay, so I will go show you in the sample. In sample I have, these are the quiz 1, this is the quiz 2. Quiz 1 marks total are 2, I have mentioned here, and you can see also the attention. When you click on this cell, it is attention, please write the total marks assigned to this quiz. Okay, so quiz 2 I have total marks 3. And now if you see the quiz 1, I have 2 questions in quiz 1, Q1, Q2, mean question number 1, question number 2. So question number 1, total marks are 1, and question number 2, total marks are also 1. So total marks for this quiz number 1 will be 2. In same way, you can see here the quiz number 2, total marks are 3. It depends on your criteria. Maybe you have 10 marks for quizzes. Maybe quiz 1, 5 marks, quiz 2, 5 marks, or quiz 1, 3 marks, quiz 2, 3 marks, quiz 3, 4 marks. So total it is 10. So it's up to you. You have to delete number of quizzes according to your requirement. But here in my course, I was having only 2 quizzes, quiz 1, quiz 2. So quiz 1 weightage, it is 2, and quiz 2 weightage, it is 3. Now we have to see how we can fill this. So quiz 1, total marks are 2, and in this quiz we have 2 questions, question 1 and question 2. Now the next step is I have to map these 2 questions with the course learning outcomes. For example, that I have filled this block, so it means the question number 1 belongs to the course learning outcome 1. Okay, corresponding we have to fill the block. So it means the question number 1 in quiz number 1, it is belongs to the course learning outcome 1. But the question number 2 in quiz 1, it is related to the course learning outcome 2. So this is the matrix I have filled. When I will fill this matrix, now next step is for the 10 students I have to give the mark. Suppose these are the 10 students I have filled. So here I given the marks. So this is the first student, Ahmed Saleh Muhammad Hussain. For example, this student got 1 marks in question number 1, but he got 0.85 in question number 2. So this is our duty, that we have to fill the marks for each students, and we give the mapping. This is the mapping, that which question belong to which course learning outcome. In same way, I have in quiz number 2, I have 4 questions. Question number 1, total marks are 1. Question number 2, total marks are 1. Now it's up to you that in the quiz, how many marks you have. So total quiz number 2, it is 3. And if you count this, 1 plus 1 plus 0.5 plus 0.5, it should be 3. So I have given, and I have given the mapping, that question number 1 belong to course learning outcome 2. Question number 2 belong to the course learning outcome 3. You can see here the corresponding value. So we have mentioned this corresponding value. Question number 3, that is total marks are 0.5. So we have mapped this with the learning outcome 1. So you can see here this is 0.5. This question also 0.5, and mapped to the CLO 1. So these are the 2 quiz in my course. So you have to fill according to your plan. So then I have put the marks. I have taken the quiz from the student and given the marks. So these marks are here. So this is the total marks obtained out of 5. Because I have 2 quiz. First quiz 2 marks, and second quiz it is 3 marks. So total marks are 5. And this is showing that this student get total, Ahmed Saleh, this get total 4.35 out of 5. And quiz number 1, his marks are 1.85 out of 2. And quiz number 2, his marks are 2.50 out of 3. And similarly, you can see for the remaining 10 students we have filled here. So I think, I hope that this is very clear. This is very important whenever you are going to complete this matrix, that you have to relate the question with the learning outcome, because this is we are using in the calculation when the report will be generated. So this I have filled. Then what is the extra? Suppose I have only 2 quiz, but here it is showing quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3, quiz 4. So remaining simply just to select, and you can delete it. So because there is no need. So after filling, we will move to the assignment. For assignment, I also have given the facility for 4 assignments. And again here you can see in this matrix that we have 6 learning outcome and these 4 are extra. Simply we have to select them and we have to delete them. Same here, the number of students we have 10, but here it is more, so just one time we have to do this. We have to select and remaining we have to delete. So we have provided the facility, we can have 4 assignments in one course according to our rules, our requirements, our criteria, whatever is according to your. So you can choose maybe 1 assignment, 2 assignment, 3 or 4. But in my course I have taken 2 assignments from the students, so remaining I have simply deleted. So assignment 1 it is 2 marks, assignment 2 it is 3 marks, and same way in assignment 1 I have total 3 questions. First question is 0.5, second question is also 0.5, and third question it is 1 mark. So then I have given the mapping that question number 1 map to CLO 1, question number 2 also map to CLO 1, question number 3 it is map to CLO 2. Then I have given the grades of the grade of the students which they got in each question. So assignment 2 it is 3 marks, so total question I prepare in this assignment 4. So it's up to you that maybe you have less than you have only 2 questions in one assignment, so it's up to you. So you have to keep them and remaining just simply you have to delete from the template. So we have filled this information and now we will move to the midterm exam. In midterm exam you can see here that I have given because according to our policy that we have 2 midterm exam, midterm exam 1 and midterm exam 2. So according to your policy you have to, you can change this text according to, maybe you are writing first midterm exam, so just simply you can update this text. So remaining it will not affect on the calculation. So after that just you have to do simply in this sheet also what is extra, just simply delete that, because we have only 6 learning outcomes and we have only 10 students, so we have to delete remaining which is extra. I have deleted this. Now we have to specify here how many questions I have to take in midterm exam 1 and how many I have in midterm exam 2. So simply here we have to specify total marks. Let's suppose total marks are 15 for midterm 1, total marks for midterm 2 also 15 according to our policy. And now it's up to the teacher that from 15 how many questions he is preparing. So if you see the sample, in sample that I have prepared 7 questions in midterm 1 and only 4 questions in midterm 2, but total weightage for midterm 1 and midterm 2 it is 15-15. So question number 1 it is 3.5, question number 2 marks for question number 2 are 2, for question number 3 it is 1.5, question number 4 it is 2, and so on. Then this is the important, we have to give the mapping that question number 1 belongs to course learning outcome 1, question number 2 also belong to course learning outcome 1, so on. This whole exam is covering the course learning outcome 1. So after that it's up to you, maybe your if let's suppose I say that this question number 3 it is not belongs to this number 1, maybe it is belongs to CLO 3, so just simply you have to change this, so this will be done. But in my case in this sample this related to the CLO 1, so then we have to complete this student marks. Okay, so for midterm exam 2 in same way you have to fill question number 1 here it is 4 marks, question number 2 it is 2 marks, question number 3 it is 4 marks, question number 4 it is 5 marks. So question number 1 belong to CLO 3, question number 2 also belong to CLO 3, question number 3 belong to CLO 3, and question number 4 belong to CLO 6. So we have filled the marks for the students. So total marks for the midterm exam it was 30. So this shows that the student number 1, Hamad Saleh, he get 21 out of 30, and in midterm exam 1 he get 10.5, and midterm 2 he get 10.5. So similarly for the other student you can see here. So this is midterm exam. Then same way you have to do the final exam for lab courses in our college, that is lab exam, theory exam, that is 40 marks. So I prepare for 40 marks. So maybe according to your policy you can do, but in template if you see the final exam, I have given the options for 15 questions. So it's up to you that how many marks. Suppose if you have 50, so you have to mention here 50. And how many questions? Suppose you have only 10 questions, then select the remaining and simply just delete them. Okay, so it will not affect the any calculation on the report. But don't delete some more extras, whatever you don't need, just simply delete them. And then we have 6 learning outcomes. So these are the extra, because this Excel sheet support 10 learning outcomes, so delete the remaining. This Excel sheet support 35 students, so from here I have only 10, so select this and delete the remaining. So now this is ready. So in sample you can see here I have only 9 questions in the final exam. Then in 9 questions I have question number 1 belong to CLO 2, question number 2 also belong to CLO 2, question number 3 belong to CLO 2, but question number 4 belong to CLO 3. So we have to give the mapping which question belongs to which CLO, because we have to assess our course learning outcome. So we will prepare our all the exams based on the learning outcome. So this is the total marks 40, and the students get this. This is blank, so it means the marks for these students are not entered. Okay, so we have to enter the marks for these students also. Then we have to go to the lab. All the courses did not have the lab. If your course did not have lab, so just simply leave this sheet, no need to fill anything. It will not affect any on the calculation. But if your course have the lab, so you have to complete this also. Suppose in the lab, in the template, we have given mid lab exam and final lab exam. So it's up to you. Maybe you did not have mid lab exam, you have lab project or something. Just simply update this text, or also you can update according to your requirement. For example, in my course, I have taken the mid lab exam for 10 marks and final lab exam for 10 marks. In mid lab exam I was having only 2 questions, question number 1, question number 2, 5 and 5. So then I have given the mapping that question number 1 in mid lab exam belong to CLO number 5, and question number 2 belong to course learning outcome 2. Similarly I have given the mapping here. Then after this I fill this student marks, then I can see here the report. That now this report you did not need to do anything. Whatever you filled in the previous sheets, this report is generated on the base of this. Now simply I will tell you, according to our policy, that if any student achieves 65%, so we say that this CLO is achieved by that student. For example, if you see we have total 6 CLOs, and if we see the template, I will show you template again, and if you see the report, we over there in template it support 10 CLOs, but in our course we have only 6, so because we already deleted them, so we need to delete from here the remaining. So this will be like this. So now we have only 6 and number of students are only 10, so we will keep the 10 and we will delete the remaining. So when you will come on the report, just you have to do 2 things. According to your CLOs you have to delete, just select them and delete the remaining, and delete the number of students. If your number of students are less than 35. So here we will go to the sample again. You can see here that CLO1, we have total 18 marks belongs to CLO1 whenever we give the mapping in matrix. So CLO1 total grade we are going to assess for 18 marks. CLO2 we are going to assess 22 marks. CLO3 18. CLO4 15. CLO5 14. CLO6 13. Now it's depend on your mapping as we have given in all assessment methods. For example, here mean you can see here this whole exam 15 marks it is mapped to CLO1. Okay, but midterm 2 it is mapped to 10 marks maps to CLO3 and 5 marks CLO6. So this is calculating whatever mapping you are giving. So total for CLO1 it is 18 in my case. In your case it can be different according to your mapping. Now we will see that for CLO1 total we have given 18. So 65% of 18, because achievement grade, if you see this one, achievement grade 65% of outcome weight, it should be, it is 11.70. So it means if any student get 11.17 or more, so it means he achieved this course learning outcome number 1. So you can see here that the first student he get 13. So it means it is more than 11.70. So it means this student Hamad Saleh Muhammad Hussain achieved this learning outcome 1. And if we see the student number 2, Hussain Al Yami, he get 11.15. So this calculation is coming from whatever we fill in the student marks. Okay, so there are some hidden rows there. It is calculating and sending the data here in this report. So 11.15, so it means 11.15 is less than 11.70. So it means the student number 2 did not achieve this CLO. Student 3 achieved because it is more than 11.70. This student also achieved. Number 5 did not achieve. Number 6 achieved. Number 7 did not achieve. 8 also achieved. 9 also achieved. So 10 also achieved. So now we can see here how many students out of 10, how many student achieved. It is total 7 student achieved. 7 student achieved this CLO. So it is 75%. So it means 3 students did not achieve. So the student not achieve, it is 30%. So it is very clear that from 10 students, 7 student achieved, 3 student did not achieve. According to our formula that we have 65%, we say if any student gets 65%, then we will consider it is achieved. So now we will see the CLO2. In CLO2, same way, the total marks for CLO2 was 22. So if we calculate the 65% of 22, it is 14.30. So according to this calculation, you can see here in this sample I will also send to you, this sample that only 5 student achieve 14.3 or more. So it means the 50% student achieve this CLO and 50% student did not achieve. CLO3, if you can see, 80% student achieved and 20% did not achieve. CLO4, 30% student achieved and 70% did not achieved. And CLO5, 90% student achieved, 10% did not achieved. CLO6, 60% student achieved and 40% did not achieve. Now we have to decide here which CLO is overall achieved. So if you see this number 1, we are saying here that 70% student achieve this CLO. So according to our criteria, if 65% student in the class they achieve the CLO, so we will say this CLO is achieved. So according to this achievement, student achievement, this is more than 65%. We say this CLO is achieved overall. CLO2 is not achieved because 65% student did not achieve in the class. Only 50% student achieved this CLO. So it means we will say this CLO is not achieved. CLO3 is also achieved because it is more than achievement. Student achievement is 80%. So this CLO is achieved. This number 4, this is not achieved because only 30% student achieve in the class. So if the 65% student achieve, we say it is achieved. So CLO5 also achieved. CLO6, this is 60%, still it is 5% less, so we will say it is not achieved. So overall we can say that CLO1, CLO3 and CLO5 are achieved in according to this result. Now for CLO2, CLO4 and CLO6, we need to write the improvement plan. So hope you will you understand how to fill this Excel sheet, and this Excel sheet will be helpful to achieve to see the achievement of the course learning outcome. So if you have any question, so you can send me email, you can contact me anytime for more information if you have any problem. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.